John Frank, the quarterback from Auburn. There will be no one talking after this.
I'm at a crossroads, lost hope and I lost quotes. My heart smokes for the fire that y'all to provoke. For the disbelievers, guess the game was missing the leader. Now they kissing my sneakers, lipstick on my Adidas. Word to the reverend, I'm running this like Russell Simmons. The game is a scrimmage, I'm stretching my muscle. It's blasphemous, blasphemous. Hazardous, hazardous, smash on they with this classic fashion. Gave them the beers, they ain't even dip. Believe it or not. Legacy mean a lot, feeding the reef for the top. Y'all dreaming, I drop. Damn, high break, free from the break. Make prisoners up a Rikers Island, think out the box. This couldn't have been predicted by the miners. Wrestling with religion and science.
Look, give me something.
Money get it till I'm a one percenter. Business is warfare. Edgar Hoover said, stop the rise of a black messiah. The judge said, charge teens as adults, turn them to lifers. Us holy, brush waves slowly, Tusker ivory beside me. Thus no slave, Toby, don't try me. We enter in the age of Aquarius.
As you load into your first game, notice the goals. Progress towards these goals will show up on the bottom ticker and near your player post play. Additionally, drive goals offered at the beginning of drives offer bonus experience opportunities. Your season starts now.
Where Ukrainian armies and U.S. National Guard tensions flaring up. So unforgiving is the universe when you don't listen. It's all written, that soul-quenching goal you're missing. Careful of ending in the ending destructive system.
Kick your season off by starting your first game.
Today we'll see John Franklin III's first start against the Baltimore Ravens at home at Sports Authority Field in Denver, Colorado. Here we go. There's been a lot of people doubting John Franklin that he would not even be picked, and a lot thought he was going to be undrafted. But he has shocked the world. Now he is the starting quarterback for the Denver Broncos. Well, you see that John Franklin could do it is in the film, Dave.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. It's opening week in the NFL, and today we have two teams are more than ready to get the season underway. It's the Broncos going up against the Ravens. So let's go down to Denver, Colorado, where Jim and Phil are on the call.
Denver's starting running back for the game is CJ Anderson. Baltimore's starting running back for the game, Justin Forsett. Akeem Lee will take back the kickoff for the Denver Broncos. We're going to be doing a slot draft. John Franklin the third. I couldn't put the three on there. They wouldn't let me. Here we go. I can it. We see. Season 14. John Park. We still don't know the team's name, really. We got a couple people.
A huge part of every offense now in the NFL. That's where the receiver starts on one side of the football, goes
down
to
the extra point here. Speed of CJ Anderson. And the quarterback that time threw it at the right time, right on target. Good yardage, just towards the first down. Running right through the trenches. Lewis is there to make the tackle.
Running back, and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
First down at the 40. Out of the pocket.
John Franklin has got pressure. Take a pass in the NFL career.
Nobody open. Instead of just freezing there, he jumps out of the pocket, looks down the field, nobody open. And a good job. Just throw the ball away.
Boop. Second and 10. See that? Anderson's going to secure the handoff.
I think when I was playing, anytime we crossed the 50-yard line, it was kind of like a big sigh of relief. Because I knew now that there were a lot of things that could take place. I could afford to take sacks. I could afford to be a little more aggressive. Let's see how the offense reacts to this.
First down at the 46. Getting away from the pressure. And now he'll dip out of bounds.
If you give him a chance, he will run the football. That's what he did that time. He tucked it in there and ran up the field, got a few yards.
Second down, four to go. The reception.
Demaryius Thomas. My fault. After picking up 11 on this
play. Can you believe how steady and reliable this guy is?
He is. What's the phrase for it? He is money, Jim Nance, man. He pays off every single time. You throw the football near him, he'll make the kick.
And let's see, Monte Ball, why did you run out of bounds? That's why you do not start, but good 22-yard rush for Monte Ball. First handoff of the year.
Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Second and goal from the six. The reception by Sanders.
I'm on the defense, and the offense is this close to scoring. I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let it. For them,
intercepted. Pass it.
Oh,
you can see the refs did not call that. I was passing first. Pass interference.
Joe Flacco. Joe Flacco can throw that ball. What else do you need to know? If you're open, he can get it to you. The Broncos back onto the field. Of course, the last drive they had it. It looked like they were going to put up some points, only to watch the football get picked off in opponent's territory.
Smart defensive coach they're going against in this game today. He knows how to put his players in positions to make plays, and he did that last drive, and they came up with the INT.
Was that on the quarterback, or was that just a great play by the defender?
I'm giving most of the credit to the defender. It's just a good play.
Anderson's lined up as the single back. Second down and two. Into the open.
When they come out and they just establish the line of scrimmage and beat the offense up.
Oh, you gotta hang on to it!
Thomas is one of those guys. He drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field. He doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver of the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
Second down and 10. Anderson is gonna take the hand. The way, third down. The Broncos all bunched up here as they get set at the line. Complete to Cody Latimer. Latimer's met after a gain of 13.
The Broncos on their offensive play sheet, they don't have many plays for third and long situations, but that is a really nice job that time by the offense, the quarterback. They pick up the first down. That'll get you going.
First down at the 39. Launches it down the field. The ball is charred out of his hands.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
Broncos have it at the 39. Brought down by Mosley.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stop him for a short gain.
At the line of scrimmage, the 34.
Let's go.
Third down and 6. He'll throw it over the middle. Thomas got the catch and the first. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. The Ravens come out in a dime package. Out of the shotgun formation. Brings it in along the sideline.
What can a defensive back do in a situation like this? The answer is nothing. How about the throw right on target by the quarterback and a good route on an out route by the receiver?
Get ready.
The Broncos take it from the 23. Broncos in the end zone.
Quarterback in the NFL as a rookie, let me tell you something, people, it is tough. It's nerve-wracking, but throwing that first touchdown, oh my gosh, it does.
The Broncos offense heading back onto the field to start the drive after the result of their last possession was a touchdown. You think they've got another one in them, partner?
Oh, I absolutely do. Well, I mean, just look at them. They got a good football team. The quarterback has great confidence and talent. And you put those things together, that makes you good. It makes you dangerous. I wouldn't be surprised to see them march down there again.
That's a nice job that time by the quarterback. He's forced out of the pocket, and when he moves, he's excellent throwing the football on the run, and he gets the completion.
Only 34 yards to the end.
We've got a defense as it is on the scoreboard.
Coming to the line at the 34.
The Ravens with a nickel look here on defense. First down at the 34. Gonna try and scramble now. He's taken down at the 30.
He is a good runner with the football, not like most quarterbacks in the National Football League. They design runs for him just to do it as a running back.
That leads us to second down. He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Demaryius Thomas with the grab.
Well, as you saw that receiver make the catch, I'll just say this. You cannot throw the football enough his way. There's no such thing. When in doubt, you don't like anything, turn and find him and throw it to him.
First down at the 19. The give. And the tackle was made by Darryl Smith.
This next snap will take place at the 19.
The Broncos line up in the pistol offense. Second and 10. For the sack.
That's an excellent job by the defense. Just gets quick penetration in there, hits the quarterback, and gets the sack. That clock keeps moving. What a job by the defense in this situation.
Third and forever. Pulls it in. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
Short passes are just as important as the long passes down the field. This time, a short, accurate pass. Look what it leads.
First touchdown.
Takes the field. Let's see if this momentum
number 16
can carry over from the first half, because they have been brilliant to this point, Parker.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've done. Of course, you've got to realize the defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half. Well, the defense, they give up a first down there. They're behind. They just can't sit back there and keep bending. You got to take some chances. Go on the offensive, on the defensive side, and just make things happen.
First down at the 49. And now he'll take off. Looking to go down the field here. Makes the catch. Touchdown.
That was a dot by John Franklin III to Cody Latimer. That was a dot. Perfectly placed pass. Good spiral. And great catch by Latimer. Did you see? Ooh, get Latimer. Hey. Short off his muscles. Coach wants them to go for a two-point conversion. I don't know why.
So, put down a touchdown and a two-point conversion on that occasion.
Yeah, good job by the offense. They executed the play perfectly, and they got in the end zone, like you said, and got that 2 points.
Broncos have done a way of a job taking their halftime lead and adding a whole lot more to it here in the third quarter.
And they're just doing everything we saw them do in the first half, just dominating the pace of play and just being more physical than the defense.
He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home, they stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short game.
Will send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. Intercepted. Philly.
The Broncos could have asked for this third quarter to have gone any better for them than it has so far, as they've just continued to do what they were doing in the first half, up and down the field.
Oh, man, they kept the pedal to the metal, man. They are letting it go. They're being aggressive, and they're trying to end this game right here.
Face mask.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a, you know, a little slack because they're running so fast. They're trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally you're going to grab the face mask.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and you saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game. After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. They bring in the extra tight end.
John Hunter used to scramble a lot for Auburn.
Picks up 8 here. One quarter to go, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Broncos will come to the line trying to put together a scoring drive here in the fourth. Now looking at third down. They'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. Catch made by Demaryius Thomas. Take a look at the numbers, and you can see the difference here, by and large, has come down to the passing attack.
It has. See, I think the coaches realized early the quarterback was hot, so what did they do? They kept giving him the football, and he kept moving it down the field.
6 catches today so far. Thomas has been option 1, 2, and 3 on offense today, Phil, as he just keeps piling up receptions at the wideout position.
Jim, he just has that special skill. He knows how to get open, and the quarterback is playing the football on the money.
First and goal. Anderson's handing the football. He breaks the play. He's in for the touchdown. That touchdown, just a little more insurance to what we're ordering.
Offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. That was a solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, just look at them, Jim. The way they run onto the field, you can see they're exuding confidence. When you've got a confident football team, man, let them go and let them play and see if they can make it happen again.
Spotting the field. Green's got it on a pass. Has some heat on it. The one who is down and will step aside for just a moment. And into the line at the 25.
I'll smash you.
And I got a goal game, you cheating asshole.
First down at the 25. Scans the field. Up in the air. And he's got the catch.
We beat. Sneaky.
I think the coach on the sidelines, he's going to be happy with every first down because he knows that's more time off the clock. When you're up like this, multiple scores in the second half, every first down just puts the odds in your favor of winning this game.
First and goal from the 10. Cody Latimer, no stopping him now. That's a touchdown. Been over for a long time, Phil, but at least we waited till midway. The Broncos offense, Phil, is on a roll right now with touchdowns coming on each of their last 2 possessions. Can they make it 3 in a row right here?
Well, we're going to find out. I like their chances. What have we seen that makes us think that they're not going to come out there and get it done? They're playing exceptional football on the offensive side.
Picked up a couple that time. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day. The Broncos lead right now, but you will see that not everything is going their way. Anderson's had a tough one, especially down the stretch. If they want to control the game, you have to think they're going to go back to him for some more touches and try to get it right.
That's right. Keep giving him the football. Keep mixing the plays up. Don't get obvious in your play calls. If you do, the defense will have everything on their side.
Broncos take it from the 28. Running away from the pressure.
Tick, 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 tick. That's what we're trying to do. Make that clock keep running down. You got the offense out there. You got a big lead in the second half. Every first down you get shortens that football game.
First and 10. Now move the chains. An extra tight end on the field for this one. First down and 10. Going deep. Makes the catch, but didn't get the feet down. Incomplete.
These NFL receivers are so fast that you just got to get rid of that football and let it go. That time, the quarterback waits a little too long, and he underthrows the receiver down the field.
Hold on a minute. They're going to stop play and take another look at that last one. There's no question he caught the ball, but there is a question whether or not he got both feet in bounds.
Well, first off, you want to make sure it's a clean catch on the sidelines. Does he have possession of the football? And then once you declare he has possession of the football, let's look down at both feet, see if they're in bounds, and don't forget, you must maintain possession of the football as you go to the ground.
Inside the last 2 minutes, this one had to be instigated by the folks upstairs. They challenged the call on the field, and in fact, it was the proper thing to do. The play is overturned.
Yeah, good job by the officials upstairs, seeing it, knowing there was a mistake on the field. That's
another touchdown to increase the lead. For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nantz saying so long.
This was an absolute demolishing game by John Franklin. Despite the two interceptions, he still prevailed against him. I'll bet Gary Kubiak is really so glad he drafted John Franklin in the first round. Now let's take a look at the news going around the league. NFL fans rejoice. The NFL regular season begins this week, several games, including the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Denver Broncos. CJ Anderson tell two touchdown runs. That's his we beat the Ravens. The Broncos found a variety of ways to score on the Ravens, and one started getting in as a blowout 42-2. Both rookies have been look like some reps, some of the legendary takers. Now let's go into a practice. Well, looks like I'm kind of drunk. Upgrade on medium and deep, that's all. That's all I want to do.
Prep before this week's game to earn XP and boost player confidence.
Let's do some engage. Cover one identification. Yeah. I got a touch of the red, not receiving my bear, y'all. Franklin was like kind of struggling with this, but that's a dot to my boy Daniels. Cause he's gonna run in front of East. Easy to them.
From what we're told, there ain't no kings in the... caution tape. Why is an honest dollar so hard to make? And no sunshine or feeling better. Watch them all scatter each other. If your daddy did, can't make them proud enough. Little boy, how you make it out of there?
Crazy.
Everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today, and there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron.
Yeah, Alex Smith.
Going up against the Broncos.
186 yards, two touchdowns. Don Franklin. 381 yards. Four touchdowns. Two interceptions.
The Broncos here for the kickoff.
See our drive goal, 20 rushing yards with CJ Anderson. We're not gonna do that right now. There's open seats, circles open. That is Demaryius Thomas.
Well, the quarterback has such great confidence in the receiver, and why not? He's talented, and every time the football's thrown his way, he finds a way to make the catch.
From the gun. In the hands of Emmanuel Sanders.
When you run that drag route across the field, it is not as easy as it looks. You're running fast, you have to catch the football right in stride, and you cannot see what's in front of you.
The Broncos take it from the 38, trying to plow ahead. Broncos are at the line facing third down, which was not an issue for them last week as they converted a number of times in crucial situations.
That's an excellent job by the quarterback getting a few yards there with the run. You know, when you play against him, of course, anytime he drops back to pass, you've got to be alert for the run.
That good punches kicks it 2 yard line. That was Smith will have to go 98 yards for a touchdown.
Touchdown passes a week ago.
Alex Smith does a little bit of everything.
Broncos heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative. Get the defense off guard. Make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity. Good job. The defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short game.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9.
John Franklin, second and 9.
Snap out of the
the gun. Thomas has got the catch.
Dang, the I used to help.
This is one of those guys, when you talk about receivers, no matter what, he is always open. If the coverage is tight, don't worry. Throw it out there. He'll make a play.
Anderson's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. Gets about 4 yards that time.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short game.
The football is at the 38. The Chiefs defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense.
Here we go.
And the tackle was made at the 35-yard line.
Always be alert for this quarterback to run the football when he gets the chance. He is excellent with it. He is a quarterback with the ability.
34. He's looking for Cardwell and Fowler on his little short route.
From the 35.
None of them open. Oh, Fowler is. Fowler.
Here, getting ready for the second quarter. Phil, that was a defensive tug of war the first quarter.
It sure was, and it was a tug of war, and it was boring. That's what it looked like. I want to give the defense some credit. I thought they did well, but really the offenses, just poor play selection, poor execution, and you got to get some emotion going out there on the offensive side. If you give him the chance, he will run the football. That's what he did that time. He tucked it in there and ran up the field and got a few yards.
They'll go shotgun here. Force it across for the touchdown. The Broncos now ready to take over again on offense. They were successful on their previous drive, getting the ball all the way to the end zone. I'm sure they're looking for more of the same right now.
Oh, absolutely. That's what you always want. You want to find your way to the end zone. And so many people contributed on that last drive, and you've got to give the coaches a lot of credit for putting the players in excellent position.
Double tight end formation. He'll take the snap from the gun. Stands in the pocket. Ball is out, and the defense has it. That brings the play to an end.
Oh, my gosh. When you're on the offensive side, you fumble the football inside your own 20. You keep your eyes down and run to the sideline and just hope the hit comes.
At least they only got three in that.
Offense back on the field, trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So if you made that mistake,
go, menu, get the first down.
Go out there, be aggressive, and see if you can score some points. The Broncos have been awesome today.
Menu for the 9-yard gain.
It's a nice play design. They throw the football, picks up solid yards, second and short. Boy, that's what every offense likes to be.
The Broncos have it at the 29.
Looks like it hikes it. Good blocks.
And it's grabbed by Latimer. And he steps out of the field of play. That's his first reception today.
A lot of people have to do a good job on play action passes for him to work. And this time, watch the running back. Nice job selling the fake. And it helps the QB.
And now we reach the two-minute warning here in the second quarter. Now as we come back to the field, following the two-minute warning, we've got a defense trying to hold strong and not allow this lead to balloon any further. First down at the 48. Oh, it almost picked off that time. Second down here. Taking the handoff. And the tackle is made right around the 39-yard line. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Running backs in the NFL now, it's hard to bring them down. That time, nice job of breaking the tackle.
Sorry guys about that. That was my mom. Sorry guys, she was just getting off working a little bit. They had a linebacker covered on that play.
Of course, it's a nice job by the quarterback getting out of trouble and throwing the football on run and getting the completion. But how about the defense? Quit being greedy. Stay in your rush lane.
Monte ball. Look at Monte ball. Look at Monte. Touchdown. Monte ball. First career.
Touchdown
reception.
Coming back onto the
defense for the Broncos is really good.
Listen, momentum is on their side, but you have that going for you. Keep the defense guessing at what you're going to do, so I think it's very important to stay aggressive in this situation.
The Broncos are going to use one of the two timeouts they have remaining. Drop back, shotgun formation. Looking to go deep. Who has it? It's the offense with the catch. Unbelievable. The Broncos really have this offense cranking, Phil. They've scored on their last two series.
You know, what we see now in the NFL, so many different ways to move an offense. Screens, run plays, power plays, trick plays. Right now, everything working on the offensive side. That's a nice play at that time by the offense, getting the first down. They're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That is a great feeling.
It's a two tight end formation. First and 10. Anderson's got on the handoff. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Scrambling out of the pocket. And Daniels has got it on a pass that had some heat. That's reception number 2 for him. If you look at these passing totals, it's easy to get a sense why they're leading right now.
Those numbers are absolutely outstanding. When you see these kind of numbers, that means the play calls were good. The offensive line had an outstanding day. And also, the wide receivers, they found ways to get open.
When you're going against a good quarterback and receiver in the NFL now, one of the ways to stop it is tight man-to-man coverage. You against him.
The Broncos will take the snap from the 35. Leaps in the air and has it. And that's a gain of 13. That receiver, Phil, is a quarterback's dream. Going high in the air on a high throw and getting the reception.
Oh, man, do quarterbacks love that? They throw it and think, oh, my gosh, that's bad. They're ready to chase the defender down with an interception. But no, the wide receiver goes up and just makes an awesome catch.
Defensive tackles, we always think of them as run stoppers. How about this that time? He does a great job, gets in there, and sacks the quarterback.
Loss of four on the play. The reception by Daniels. And Daniels is marked down after a gain of nine.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Third down at five. The reception by Demaryius Thomas.
Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. And that's Johnson in on the stop.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stop him for a short gain.
Second down and nine. Takes it again. He'll pick up seven this time.
Well, once you get in the red zone, you find out how powerful your offensive line is sometimes. And what a good job that time by the O-line. They showed that power, and they picked up solid yards on that one play.
Anderson's going to secure the handoff. That's DeVito making the stop.
Jim, the defense gives up the first down that time inside the red zone. But there's only so many things the offense can do. Let's see if they can hold them.
The Broncos with an empty backfield look here.
Broncos face for a first and goal situation here.
Now on the move.
Let me scramble, y'all.
Mounting a serious drive. Second and goal at the one.
Runs
it across. Touchdown.
Another rushing touchdown for John Franklin III.
The Broncos take the field again on offense. They'll be looking for a repeat of their last drive. They came away with a touchdown and really had the defense on its heels.
Well, it's going to be hard to repeat what they just did because it looked so easy and it was well done by their offense. And I think when you talk about situations like this, it really comes down to one thing. Can the offensive line continue to dominate?
And Daniels is tackled right at the 35. Looking at these numbers now, you see the big target like this getting back in the swing of things. Phil, a week ago, he was basically shut out, and today he cannot be stopped.
Well, we see a lot of smiling faces, don't we, on the sideline. The coach is happy, and of course, the quarterback, he's the happiest guy of all because he loves his tight end target. Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second down and five. And it's incomplete. Just can't hold on that time.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
The Broncos have to get to the 25 to move the chains. Green's going to pull in the bullet pass.
Good job by the offense here with a good lead in the second half, picking up that first down, and that's what you want to do. Take your time, look at the play clock, take it down as low as you can, and keep picking up those first downs.
Could have been intercepted.
That's a nice play that time by the defense. The offense is inside your red zone. You've got to stop them from scoring. That was a good job of swatting the football away.
Let's go.
From the gun. Justin Houston with the sack.
That's an awesome job by the outside linebacker. Gets a sack on the quarterback.
Getting sacked. Your freshman just got sacked.
You got to be tough against the run. Cover the receiver down the field. And yes, plays like this get the
support. Devin Barker's going to have to settle for 3 points.
Good job by the defense at time. They play smart. Third long, cover the deep receivers, make the quarterback throw it short on third and long.
And he converts here on the field goal try. Midway through the fourth, and that field goal almost makes this game look like it's over. I know it's not, Phil, but that's a huge three.
Well, at a time like this, when you have a lead midway in the fourth quarter, you got to understand the situation.
The Broncos bring their offense onto the field. The last time they had control of the football, they did not come away empty-handed, but did not get a touchdown either.
Well, they got that field goal. I think that's important. That field goal gave them a little confidence. They got some points up there that always makes you feel good on the offensive side. Now take advantage of that good feeling. Go out there and score a touchdown this time.
And see if they can finish off a drive. Anderson's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back.
Your offense was just looking to run out the clock. But they're going to pass the ball. Wow. Oh, that would have been at least a touchdown right there. But number 46 makes a good read on the ball. Good jump on the ball.
So he didn't put all his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
Second down and 10.
We're just going to run the ball.
Trying to find it open to the right. Anderson's taken down. The 33.
He's an man.
After that run, third and 8 for the offense.
Here we go.
The Broncos have to get to the 25 to move the chains. Takes off with it. He's into the open. And he's going to slide feet first.
Not as easy as it looks. That quarterback, good job of sliding before he takes the hit that time.
He'll try this one from 43. And he puts it through for 3. The clutch kick and the 3 points, and virtually everyone here knows that that clinched it.
Yes, that did it, Jim. Now you can just take a deep breath knowing all that hard work during the week.
John Furman picks up another W in his second game in the NFL. The Denver Broncos are now 2-0. Here are the post-game stats. Denver Broncos are leading in all the stats except one in takeaways. Leading in score, passing yards, rushing yards. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video of John Franklin. See you guys in the next episode, which will be coming out today.